Yes, yes, yes. Hey, 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 welcome back to another week at the Stay Focused podcast. I am your host, Artie Delgado of BRINK Films. First of all, man, another week goes by and we are super pumped about the podcast. We are excited about all the listeners and viewers. We thank you guys for your support. You guys really are what make this show, and we are glad to be able to bring any experience we've got to the table, and we hope you keep enjoying that. So keep tuning in, spread the word on that. We really want to get this show out, and we feel that it's been impactful. We get a lot of good feedback back on that. Today, super pumped about what we're going to be talking about today. We've been asked a lot about working, why we work with nonprofit organizations. We've been doing that for a number of years now. I find a very big impact in my personal life based on that. And so I want to go straight to one of the questions that comes to us directly from Atlanta from our good friend Daniel McCullough, who writes us and says, I love Brink because they proved that not every LA guy is a snob. Thanks, Daniel. And not every production company wants to compete. Ever since I've known Artie, he has been nothing but encouraging to me in my pursuit for building my production business. I have looked to him for advice and inspiration continuously. Thanks, Daniel. Appreciate that, man. But then he goes on to actually ask the question, when choosing to work with a nonprofit, potentially without pay, is that, as a business, a loss to you financially, time, resource, etc.? And also then wants to know, what do you gain from taking on a project like that? And so today I brought in a very special guest, somebody who I would say couldn't be more perfect of an example of why we work with people doing and making a difference within the inner city. I have a special friend I've known for 20 years plus, my good, good close friend, Eric Vasquez. Eric, man, thanks for being here.
Yeah, I appreciate no problem, you. Man. I'm honored.
Appreciate you being here. And we have a close relationship. We've known each other for a long time. Yep. And, you know, like I said, a lot of people are asking all the time why we do what we do with guys like you. And, you know, leadership is huge in what we do. And I think that with filmmakers and guys that they do what they do, they need to be able to find good leaders, be around that, I think.
Yeah.
But let's just get right into it, man. I want to just kind of hear a little bit of background on,
I don't know if they're ready, man.
There's too much. I don't think they don't know the history we have together, but yeah. Is it probably been at least 20 years?
Yeah, it's just about that, man.
20 years plus.
Yeah.
Tell me about how the first time we met. How was the first time I met you, and what was that like?
I was a youngster. I was a teen, dude. I remember I was chasing some dope hip-hop. I was real into the scene, the underground scene, and I was just trying to find some real positive music that was really... I was going through a life change at that time, where a lot of my younger years, I was just straight lost, you know? Mm-hmm. That's the best way I could put it. And then I rolled on a scene where you were holding, you know, mic in hand and rocking the stage. Yep. And I was like, man, I was really drawn to your music and your personality on stage. And then I remember afterwards, I made an effort to connect to you personally, and you were really open and just like, what's up, dude? You know, to me as a young man, seeing somebody not too much older than me who was chasing their dream, you know, doing something that I was passionate about as well, I really took to it, and I began, you know, following some of your shows and some of the cats that you were working with, and that was a real exciting season of my life. So it was dope, man, how we met.
Yeah, and I remember, man, every time I do that stage, you were like right there in front with your crew. So yeah, lots of history there. And then just to see many years go by now, 20 years later, and to see the leadership that you're doing. I want to give a little bit of background on what you do so they can understand exactly why it is we team up together. But talk to me about your organization. You run an organization called Justice for Youth. You've been leading that for a number of years.
Yeah.
You are dealing with urban youth and urban cities, and specifically the city of Pomona itself.
Yeah.
But give me a little rundown of what exactly that actually is all about.
Okay. I kind of, you know, it started when we met, really. I really felt this calling to begin to impact some of the homies that were around me. When my life changed, I started seeing the direction they were going, and it was not good, right? So that's where the vision started. But right about when I was about 19, I started really, really visioning for this and putting it on paper. I started working with kids, youngsters in some of the most at-risk, high-crime neighborhoods, gang-affiliated, and my heart only grew and got more passionate for that. So we formally founded Justice for Youth. It's a little bit of a wordplay. Justice is a word for Christ, so I am a faith-filled dude. You know, I give God all the glory for the change that he's done in my life, but also you know, it has that emphasis of restorative justice. We really care about keeping kids out of jail and keeping them out in the community and having some solid mentorship around them. And then I was kind of looking across the landscape of the city and saying, man, these dudes are boo-boo. No one's really doing any good work with these youngsters. Right. They're slipping through the cracks. So it was like just us, right? So we focus on mentoring. We're on 12 different schools in the Pomona Unified School District. So we chase after them. And then we have creative alternatives during the week where they're able to come on out and have positive alternatives, stay off the streets, stay disconnected from some of the challenges, and then stay connected to positive role models in their life. For a lot of us, we act as surrogates. We just did this study, bro. It's about 73% of the students that we work with, which is about 812 students right now, are fatherless. So we really stand in the gap for absentee parents. And we support these kids, man, through everyday life. And to see the life change that comes from those meaningful relationships, it's like, man, it makes me want to keep chasing it and chasing it hard.
Yeah. And, you know, the fact is, to get into the why relating, people want to know, why we're bringing Eric Vasquez? He's a nonprofit organization. He does these in the city. But the relative back to connection between you and I has been where I've been influenced mostly from you as well. You know this, you and I have had many talks, but I think from filmmaker guys that understand where it is, why I take on projects, things that the question literally has been asked, why do you work with so many nonprofit organizations? Why, you know, their budgets may not be there, or how do you find the time? You know, we know that. Where do you find the time to be able to build that into your production when you were busy doing other project music videos in between everything? So the reality is to know that I have been inspired from you and what your organization has done and the things that we have been teamed up to tell those stories. You know, I want our people to know that, like, when we take on projects like you, we learn so much. A lot of what I've built is we want to make a difference. I always teach this quite a bit, is impacting. You know, we want to impact with filmmaking.
Yeah.
That is really what we want to do. Every project that we want to take on, we want to have purpose behind what we do. And so to see and to be honored, I want you guys all out there listening to this, is to know that we can make a difference with our filmmaking process.
You have.
We try to do that, but teaming up with nonprofit organizations, they have stories. These are the people that are also making differences in the streets, like you guys. I mean, I watch you with your kids, man. And when you are with these boys, these guys look to you like a real father figure. Yeah. I mean, and you have your own kids. Bro, you got three kids of your own.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? So this is not like you're not a father. You got your own kids, but yet you believe these are also your kids. I see you giving these kids rides.
Yeah.
I see you borrowing cars and vans to get these kids to these events.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? These kids know that you believe in them and you love them, and they have an unconditional love that is something that I see and has been inspiring for me. So to kind of look back a 360 back on our lives, to see that one day you were watching me on stage as a fan, I literally look back at you and look at you as a fan to see what you do, and I'm inspired by that. And for us as the BRINK team, we want to be involved in things like that.
Shout out to BRINK, man. I mean, first of all, just how you guys have grown in your art, but the way that you've been able to work with us and tell our story, bro, has been amazing. I feel like you guys just have an ability to just capture the heart of whatever's going on and then to communicate it really well. And for cats like me, who are young, emerging leaders and don't always have the resources, you know, I think your company, your brand, man, has really identified a lot of the times the underdog and believed in us, you know? And I feel like that's who you guys are as well. You know, you've come from the bottom, and through hard work and commitment and passion, you know, you've been really able to be really successful. And I really appreciate that BRINK and the team believes in us and is willing to partner with us. I will say it's because of your partnership that we've been able to expand our business. Just simply sitting down with some of these principals, bro, and being able to show them a 1 minute clip, a visual of what we do, captures their heart and takes us to that next level where they can give us their trust to work with their most high-risk students that they haven't been able to be effective with. And through some of your work with us, it says, hey, here we are, loving, consistent mentors. We can be successful with these kids. They do have a future. And I really appreciate that, man. So yeah, shout out to you and your team.
Thank you, man. It's been a definitely a team effort with the team that believe in the vision as well. Yeah. I'm here speaking, but I got a team behind me that believes in the vision of those type of things. And I try to teach that in every one of them, is to make sure that they know there's a bigger purpose in what we do. If I wouldn't be satisfied if I was just doing rap videos all the time. You know what I mean? That's not going to satisfy me in life. And if through my art and filmmaking, I want to make differences. And so the impact that's where we have the ability of having the power of telling story. The things that you're doing, bro, to get that out is what we want to be able to share and get that out and tell that story in such a passionate way where it affects more people to get your vision out. Mm-hmm. And that's where filmmakers don't understand sometimes that really is how you can actually make impact. You are telling stories, getting these things out, telling it in such a way even more powerful. As viewing now, they get to see it in a minute. Like you said, it was a minute clip and it tells a whole vision in 1 minute. And so we have the power to be able to do that. And then, you know, what's really cool is the relationships built even more because of that. Not only yourself, but you also team up with other organizations like UIWI, also working with Urban Youth Workers. And that also has been another thing where you've implemented a lot of what they do with is what Manhood Camp has been doing, which also is dealing with, you know, kids and urban city kids and getting them to, these are raised without fatherless, right?
They've been very impactful in our life. Yeah.
UIWI has been a very big impact to you and myself. We've also teamed up with them again, another nonprofit organization that also really is impacting cities and urban kids. And so we believe in that and we want to tell that story. Has been impactful. And then to even go into what's come out of even later, the relationship's even grown into better. We even brought you in to the premiere we did last year, 2 years ago.
Yeah, man, that was fun.
I mean, two years in a row, we did two premieres.
That was cool.
And we brought in you guys to come and speak as a panel. Remember that?
Me and some of my students, right? Yeah.
And so we were able to actually take a premiere on a music video that we shot, which was completely non-relevant to any, you know, nonprofit organization whatsoever. We did a premiere and we actually raised money for UIWI's Manhood Camp that year just by having people coming view our music video, which was another little niche we found pretty impactful. And then the very next year, we did another one on Downrange, which we're going to be doing an episode on that too as well.
Wow.
To talk
that
about
was
that
big,
project.
Man. That was fun.
That was a fun project. And then you hosted that.
Yeah, I did that.
Talk about your experience. What was that like, you just coming in to be able to host something like that?
Man, first of all, for it to kind of play out the way it did, full circle, in my city, you know, in the heart of the arts colony, Fox Theater, historic spot, you know what I mean, where I've gone and seen so many shows and everybody knows it. That was dope. That was the first thing. But man, it was a really great experience. So many beautiful people came out there. So much support came around that vision that you guys had to support the cause. And for me, hosting, it was an honor getting to know some of the crew that were involved in the actual film. And then just being able to see your process and promote it, man, and be about it that day was very special for me and Justice for Youth to get behind that. So it was dope, man.
Yeah. And I think that really starts to spark up the real vision of what can come out of something.
Yeah, that partnership. Yeah.
That partnership, man. Just being able to take something on, which, you know, you say your team, well, we're not getting paid for this. It may not be a budget ability to it, but this is where we start to understand there's more to getting out of taking on a project. Right. We actually start now to look for these projects rather than waiting for them to come our way. Where again, we want to have purpose behind everything we end up filming to make differences and impacts. Yes, we will do the other projects as well.
Yeah.
We will do the corporate kind of stuff. We'll still do music video, those kind of things, but the passion and what we film can make impact, and dealing with, like, being able to have the opportunities of filming guys like you is a big part of what we do. We also want people to understand too, like when they are hiring Brink, or that when they bring us on board, this is also what they're supporting. They're also allowing us to be able to, you are also supporting us to be able to do some of these projects aside from these other things. This is why we started up, you know, we've got the brand and the clothing line and the hats and the gear,
so
the sweaters, all of that.
Understand.
When they actually support the ability of offsetting those things, this also supports us being able to say, we take some time regularly throughout the year to be working with these nonprofits on our own time, and that supplements that. So keep that in mind, guys. When you guys are actually supporting or bringing or looking for a film, you know, crew to bring in, when you do bring us on, you are all supporting the things that we're doing offline.
Yeah, that's
the things,
big.
That's huge, and I think that's something that we want to definitely promote and let them know that this is happening. They just don't know it, and so. That's what that support of that gear and stuff does. So it's really helpful to do that. Now, what would you, if you were to say, like, what is next for you? What's going on with the latest? And just to talk a little bit more, what we were teaming up on some things too. We've got this, you got a fashion show coming up that we've been teaming up with. So what's kind of next on the horizon, what we're doing?
Yeah, so I mean, the fashion show is our next big thing. We've identified students on several campuses. And we're trying to be creative to find something that would be really good to empower them. We committed to do a fashion show. We'll have about 24 students who will be walking the stage, and we're selling tickets right now to fill the room so these kids can really feel the sense of a big event. We're gonna have a live DJ and MC, you know, really making it big. The first hour, we are also bringing in some of our youth artists, and they're gonna be selling their art. And we really believe in those cats and wanna help them have that entrepreneurial spirit and learn that they can create a little hustle for themselves, right? By doing what they're passionate about. So that's one big thing. The next big thing though, man, keep us in your thoughts and your prayers, dude. We just submitted some content for a couple grants. And what we're trying to do, man, which is big, and I know Brink is in support of us because you see what we do out there. We are trying to go into four of the highest crime, high risk neighborhoods, north, south, east, west part of the city. We're going to do a program called the Brotherhood and Sisterhood Project. We're going to identify 30 to 40 fatherless youth, male, female, and we're going to take them through a year-long program. The intent is to create rite of passage for these students. We see the abandonment and the rejection and how it's causing such anger and then creating violence in our community. As you know, Pomona is one of the highest crime and high violent cities in the LA County and even this way. As we kind of border San Bernardino County. So we want to identify those kids, which are indigenous leaders in our communities, bro, influencers. We want to work to stand in the gap as surrogates, and we're going to journey with them for a year with rite of passage celebrations. We're going to clearly define what it looks like to be a young man and a young woman. And we're going to look them in the eye, man. We're going to shake their hand at the end of the year and say, welcome to manhood. Welcome to womanhood, mija. You know, now you know what it means to be a man and to be a woman. And we've made this acronym, it's called REAL, from a book that we had read. It's rejecting passivity, engaging community, accepting responsibility, and leading courageously. So throughout the year, the seasons, they'll accomplish and know, like, hey, when I do these things, that's really the marker, the benchmark to say, I'm becoming an adult, I'm becoming a man, I'm becoming a woman. So that's huge for us because, as I spoke about earlier, the number one rising statistic is that there's fatherlessness across the city, man, and it is ravaging our community. So that's coming up this summer, 2018.
And just to even add to that, the impact of what you guys are doing too, like even just this, the fact that the fatherlessness, the things you're teaching these young guys, I mean, there's some basic things that that you guys teach them. I mean, you implemented a lot with Manhood Camp doing, but teaching kids how to even tie a tie.
Yeah.
How to even put a tire on a car, how to rotate a tire on the car, how to, you know, you got to wear deodorant. You know what I'm saying? You want to get old, you want to talk to females.
Yeah, here's how you shave, bro.
You know what I'm saying? And it was unbelievable on some of the questions that were asked. I hear some of these kids like, do you wear deodorant every day or what's the deal? I mean, these are things that usually father would have taught. And it was eye opening even for me to go, wow, this is the real deal. This is where you guys are actually really in the mix.
Yeah.
This is out there and people don't understand that. And for us to be able to honor to tell that story, man, is something that's really affected me and really passionate in my heart. And we believe in what you're doing, man. So supporting you is exactly that. We do support you along with other people like UIWI and what they're doing. But I gotta say, just you guys are doing it. I mean, it's the real deal. The real street level, you are doing it with these kids, and the love that you have for these kids is amazing.
You should tell them about how the Brink lead goes out every Sunday and balls up with
Yeah. That's another thing too. Is that we play ball on every Sunday. Every Sunday they play ball with these kids, and man, these kids ain't no joke, man. They're high school kids, but they're dunking. You know what I'm saying? So it's really good to get out with them. And you guys, that's one thing to really understand is that, you know, really, when you invest with these nonprofits, you work with guys that are doing this, it's about relationships.
Yeah,
it is
right.
Not about just showing up and you just filming this thing and be done, man. It's about really building in depth interaction, intentional, relationship building. And so that's exactly what we do. I mean, that's why I build with you on a regular. We were intentionally talking about that. And we've got more. We talk about life. We talk about your kids. We talk about health. We talk about, all of that together. And
just a plug for Brink, man. I mean, those of you who are listening, I think that's what you get when you bring Brink on. You know, it's not just somebody that's there to do the job. They're there and they're out. You know, you guys invest relationally. And I think any project that they'll serve that you guys really work with, I think that's where you really get the fullness of what the project, what they want it to be about. You know, I think that's what I appreciate most. You're so relational, you know, so down to earth, and yet your level of professionalism, man, is ridiculous. And the product that you kick out, I'm always very proud of some of the stuff that you guys have been showing. And I brag on you guys 24/7, man.
Thanks, bro. Yeah. It's I love what we do, man. We love it. And when you're that passionate, just like you are with what you do, it comes natural. It's a lot of work, but it comes off looking like it's a natural thing. But that's just because we're super passionate about it. So we will continue supporting you and what you do. We look forward to the continued projects that we can help out with. And I love our
Thank
friendship.
You,
and you know, where can we find a little bit more information on what you do?
Okay.
And where can they find more stuff about?
Yeah, they can
about
go. I think the best way is to go on our website. It's simple, man. It's JU4Y.org. And then if you do the social media thing, man, we're on every social media platform. It's at just us, 4Y. And you'll see we got a lot of stuff going on, tons more than I even mentioned. You know, today we really believe in keeping those kids active and busy. So that's where you guys can find us.
Yeah, very good, man. Well, hey, thank you for being here. Guys, I want you guys to understand that today's the whole message to today is your ability to be able to find work and be able to find yourselves getting better at what you do isn't just about waiting on the projects to come your way. It's really about going out after it, going out, finding the project, building relationships with people, and seeing how you can actually help and make a difference to somebody else above and beyond your own gain is something that I've been affected by. And so that's what we continue to do. So I encourage you guys, when you guys are out thinking about that, and when people ask, you know, what if there's no budget? And what if they're low on budget? And think about where you are trying to be in this game. Where do you want to end up? Where will you be satisfied in what you end up completing when you're done with this life? What will you be satisfied? For me personally, if I never actually work on that, that high end, you know, Avatar movie, and it stresses my life has gone to crap because I worked on that film, I'll be good. I'll be happy if I'm literally making change, being successful, making a great living at what we do, but also making change.
Yeah.
To me, I'd be satisfied. So for you guys out there that are actually finding these things, nonprofits are a huge way to get started. There's a couple of techniques on that too, is that they don't require a lot. They are lucky to be able to mostly have you. If you're a good enough cinematographer and you're a good DP or you're a good filmmaker, they're lucky to have you, first of all, and you being able to practice and do great work and what you can tell in story is a great opportunity, because it's a win-win all the way around. You win because you're gaining practice. You're getting to be better at what you do. At the same time, the nonprofit is really gaining by the ending product that is getting their story out. And believe me, guys, they will push your video hard because they don't have the opportunities or budget to afford something like what we do.
That's good, man.
And so they will market that thing, and you will be surprised on what will come out of it. And we have then even built in with, we're part of the City of Commerce. We deal with a lot of that because we find that there are more organizations just like yours that end up needing more help. And so those are the kind of things that we get out of it. So just keep that in mind when you guys are out there wondering, you know, I don't know, I don't find enough work, or I'm not finding out what to do. That would be something to keep in mind and what you guys end up being effective in your filmmaking. So I think that's pretty much what I wanted to get out today, man. I can't thank you enough for being here.
Thank you guys, man. It was a blessing.
Yeah, dude. I think it's great to hear your side of the story, and I thank you for your friendship, first of all, bro, and a lot about what we will continue to do. And and make a difference. And so if you guys want to learn more about it, please look up that website about what they're doing. And if you guys, again, want to support more, go to BrinkBaby.com and you can find out more about what we are doing and the latest projects that we are filming, and as well as you can buy products. You'll be able to see the podcast at BrinkBaby.com. And really support, man. That's really what we need. We want to thank you again for today's podcast. Stay focused out there, and we'll see you next week. Thanks, guys. Up, turn the volume up and bang it out the truck. Now. Turn the volume up and bang it out the truck. Now. Turn the volume up and bang it out the truck. Now. Come on. Turn the volume up and bang it out the truck. Now. Turn the volume up and bang it out the truck. Now. Turn the volume up and bang it out the truck.